Hi, Jim Van Zandt, one of the pastors here, Carlisle United Methodist Church, sermon in 3 minutes. Last Sunday, we kind of honored Memorial Day, as we should, as a nation, and certainly as a church. And in my message in the morning, I told a bit of the biography story of Benedict Arnold, who's forever remembered as America's traitor. And that's a shame. He was quite a great military strategist. Brilliant person, even people on both sides of the struggle remarked how brilliant he was, and some have even suggested that he could have been in competition to become our first president instead of George Washington had he stayed here. But he's forever remembered for one single act of selfishness, being America's first traitor. Even to this day, I've never met a person named Benedict. Interesting in itself, to be sure, but the larger question is the question we've been asking each of the last couple of weeks as part of a sermon series. What would Jesus say to? And then each week we've been putting in a very differing topic. This week the question is, what would Jesus say to those who want to be remembered, to those who want to leave a legacy? And what I believe Jesus would say to those who want to leave a legacy, he would say, be careful what you wish for. Why? Because it's a slippery slope. Because the desire to be remembered can actually take over your life and can change your behaviors and your actions as you become very self-centered and self-absorbed, which is very different than what being a servant of Jesus Christ is called to be and to do. So we can set in motion a whole set of behaviors and actions that can take us down a road of destruction. My question to you today is, what do you want to be remembered for? That's an important question to think about, because the answer may determine how we live our lives in the present, those things we want to be remembered for, whether they're positive things or negative things, because some of us may not be remembered for the things we want to be remembered for. Think about that this week as you move forward in your activities and actions. You may have not thought so much about that, but give it some thought, because it has an important connection to how we live our lives daily. Thanks for tuning in, Sermon in 3 Minutes.